And again, we are having the windmills, great windmills, pneumatic electrical power by the air. To erect that simple one mill, how much does it cost? With one, how much we are getting? With two, how much we are getting? With 100, how much we are getting? And what is the cost over there? Means economically viability also we have to see for that to generate electricity. Economically, if it is low, we need not to pay more for the electricity. Very low we can, or one time we can have our electrical solar panels overhead our house. We may generate enough for our night consumption. We may generate enough for our TV set to run. We may generate enough for our cell phones to run. See to it. And it is renewable. Now, today, the sun is not there. Tomorrow it will be there. The panels are open. And tomorrow we are collecting again electricity. We are using and we are collecting, storing. That way, it is economically viable, clean, and by the danger side also, it is not that dangerous. So, solar energy works cheaper than fossil fuel resources. If I am putting petrol into my vehicle, I am just thinking, is it, that means whether I am using it for the full 3 days, full 2 days. Likewise, because I have to go to workplace, I don't utilize it for the kilometer wise. Because kilometer wise, the companies say 60 kilometers per 1 liter. They may say 70, they may come up with 80. But there will be a condition over there. What is one? Subjected to road condition of your locality. Your road condition are very poor, then you have to raise your boom, boom, boom. Means what? You are using more power without output. Then your consumption levels are coming down. Our consumption is more and running is less. So you are running from here to there with the electrical panel overhead. It may be cheaper. Charging a battery over there is maybe cheaper. So it can be vital, once we master techniques to harness solar energy, still we are finding out the cheaper means and ways to harness. Harness means to what? To collect it, gather it and collect it. Gather and collect is harness, H-A-R-N-E-S-S. Once if we have a viable and cheaper harnessing system with us, that is, whenever the sun is there, the car can run. If it is cloudy, if car doesn't run, if it is rainy, we have to stick to one place, then again, it poses danger. And hence, viability also we have to see, and the storing system also we have to develop. From the solar system, we are storing here, and the battery is renewed, and the battery is running the car. That way we are getting up the cheaper means to collect that harnessed energy. It can be a vital source of power on all planets. See, our sun is there and around that there are many planets, right? And all these planets are getting solar power. The heat energy they are getting, every planet. So if at all we harness the system, we develop a system to turn the solar heat into your electricity, then it is useful wherever you go, into any planet you go. Solar energy could be a viable source of power generation for the next 1,000 crore years. Not 1,000 years, not 10 years, not 100 years. What we are bothering is, if I buy a vehicle, if I am comfortable on that, it's okay. That way you need not have to be a selfish. Why? The solar energy, through the heat what we are getting, through the radiation, it is enough to run any vehicle, anything for thousand crore years, not thousand years alone, thousand crores. There are many technologies available for conversion of solar energy into solar power. Solar energy converted to solar power. There are many techniques and there are many jigmos also we have. For instance, solar photovoltaic, SPV, solar power, solar photovoltaic, SPV technology, photogalvanic cells, solar steam generators, solar concentrating power, that is again, solar tower or solar chimney, radio micrometers and thermopile are some of them. These are the some of the things where we are getting solar heat and we are converting into solar energy. That way we are converting it. Electric motors. Now, when we go for this electric motors, let us understand what is a motor now. What is a motor and what is a dynamo we are reading in physics. Motor is electrical power to mechanical power. Dynamo is mechanical power to electrical power. Converts it. Dynamo and motor. And here we are talking about motors. Imagining a future where clean air is no longer a dream and our cities are not smog-filled, concrete jungles could well become a reality in the coming years if the world begins to increasingly adopt the use of cleaner options like alternate fuel vehicles. Now, let us just imagine. We should have jungles with plants, but population is increasing. We are planning it, we are controlling it, everything is there. But even then, it is increasing. Why? Because the multiplicity is a natural phenomenon. It has to. If a man has two sons, the two sons have two, then it is in the increasing only. It will never stop unless the man stops generating. That we cannot do. It has to be generated. So, slowly what happens is we have to occupy every inch which is supposed to be left for the plants. Then every fellow wants his own residence, a place to shelter himself. I don't say residence means a pakka building. Then now we have the already apartment culture. 20-storied building. Maybe then the every city may become a concrete jungle. Means the radiation of sunlight will be more and more and more. 5 years ago or 10 years ago, the temperature levels were not this. Now we are finding, it has crossed 47. Next year it may cross to 52. Why this? It may cross to. Do you mean to say there are two suns burning in the sky? They are emitting that kind of a heat here, doubled it. In fact, the solar heat is reducing. But we feel the temperature is increasing. Why that? Earlier, radiation is directly falling on the earth and the earth is emitting the very same, reflecting the very same heat, and that reflection is irregular because the earth is not smooth everywhere. So because of the irregularity, and we were arresting that radiation, that is the reflection of heat, we were regulating it, having thatched roofs, having this tiled roofs. What were we doing is, we were restricting the reflection of heat. Radiation was curbed. Now we are having the concrete building, very smooth outside. And so the reflection is very irregular, right? And that very regular reflection, again, you have the tar roads or concrete roads. There also the reflection of heat is more. One from the sun and one from the concrete reflections. Then what will happen? You just think about it. Right? So there, what happens is, for instance, filled concrete jungle could well become a reality in the coming years if the world begins to increasingly adopt the use of cleaner options like alternate fuel vehicles. Not only that, your vehicles are emitting smoke. Emitting smoke means what? It is just like a balloon to have that heat carry with them. Because it cannot mix into the air. Air has also a capacity to take in certain thing. If it can't take it, it will be leaving it. That makes radiation. The pollution may also cause more radiation of heat. Because the air cannot contain that. Right? So we have to think about more other alternative fuels and emitting energy. The rise in economic activity and the burgeoning population have led to a tremendous demand in the transport sector, especially in urban India. By 2020, India's urban population is expected to grow fivefold to a staggering 200 million, while pollution is expected to grow 7 times. You see the statistics. By 2020 means only 3 years more to go. What would happen? The thing what we are going, which as we have studied, tremendous demand for transport sector. Now, for every festive season, the state transport and the railway. Not only these two, these airways also. They are increasing their plying their own means of transport between two places. They are increasing. Even then, by 2020, it should be put to 5 times more. Now just imagine your Panchakutta junction or any square of any city. Just imagine. Now it is already a standstill position for us together. And if it is fivefold, then what would occur to you? And even if you are there in that stagnated traffic, you feel itching all over your body because of the pollution levels. If it is fivefold increase of population fivefold, but transportation necessities increase 7 times. That is the statistics by 2020. Unless you go for some other alternative fuel, right? Whatever you feel that it is enough, fuel is there, petrol is there, that may also come to a zero level one day.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.